I am Priyadarshini, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Applications. Today we are going to discuss about database. And first we see in database, what is database? A database is a collection of related data. By data we mean it is a known facts that can be recorded and that have implicit meaning. And database properties, it represents some aspect of the real world that is called the mini world. The changes to the mini world are reflected in the database, and it is a logically coherent collection of data with some inherent meaning. A random assortment of data cannot correctly be referred to as a database. It is designed, built and populated with data for a specific purpose. And database applications, the database is used in variety of fields, and first one is a banking sector. For customer information, accounts, loans and for banking transactions. And next in universities, it is used to store the student information, course registration and grades. And next is the sales. It is used to store the customer, product and purchase information. And next airlines for storing the reservation and schedule information. And next is the credit card transactions. It is used for purchase on credit cards and generating a monthly statements, that is printed record of account activity. And next, human resources, is used to store the information about employees, salaries, payroll, taxes and benefits, and for generation of paychecks, that is salary account. And telecommunication, for keeping record of calls made, generating monthly bills and maintaining balances on prepaid calling cards and storing information about the communication network. And next is the finance sector, for storing information about sales and purchases of financial instruments such as stocks and bonds. And next is the manufacturing sector, for management of supply chain and for tracking production of items in factories, inventories of items in warehouses and stores, and orders for items. And next is the database management system, that is DBMS. And DBMS is a collection of interrelated and set of programs to access those data. The collection of data usually referred to as the database, which contains information related to an enterprise. And it is a collection of programs that enables user to create and maintain a database. And database fulfills the different purposes. First one is defining, it is specifying the data type, structures and constraints for the data to be stored in the database. And next, constructing, it is the process of storing the data itself on some storage medium that is controlled by the DBMS. And next is a manipulating, that is adding, updating and deleting the process, etc. The sharing of databases among various users and applications. And different database management systems are MS Access, MySQL and SQL Server, Oracle, PostgreSQL, FoxPro and SQLite. And next is the application program and a database system. The application program accesses the database by sending queries or requests to the database management system. A query is the interaction with the database, that is example, retrieving or manipulating the data. And database system, the database management system software and the application program together are called a database system. And next we are going to see about characteristics of database. The number of characteristics distinguish the database approach from the traditional approach of the programming with files. The self-describing nature of the database. The database system contains not only the database itself, but also a complete definition and description of the database structure and constraints. Database abstraction. It allows the program data independence and program operation independence. And next characteristics is multiple view of the data. Some users may not need to be aware of whether the data they refer to is stored or derived. One user of the database may be interested only in the transcript of each student. The second user, who is interested only in checking that the students have taken all the prerequisites of each course they register for. And next application is sharing of data and multi-user transaction processing, that is concurrency control to manage the transactions. A transaction is an executing program or process that includes one or more database access, such as reading or updating the database records. And next, the actors on the scenes, that is who, what roles do the people take around the database system. First one is database administrators, and next is the database designers, and next end users, and finally the application program, that is software engineers. First we are going to discuss about database administrator. When the database is designed and implemented, it is handed over to the database administrator. He is the person who is responsible for the database during its lifetime, and he manages the user accounts, hardware resources, backup, and etc. And next is the database designer. The database designers conceptually design and implement the database. He analyzes the requirements for the database and gather all the information about the application fields. And he designs the conceptual schema, and he chooses the choice of the database management system. And next is the end user. The end user or the people who will use the database when it is finished. It is normally, he requires the normally a little technical knowledge, and he is the person who uses the database. And next, finally, it is the application programmers. He is the programmers that write the programs that uses the database. The programmers of a graphical user interface for the database. And next, the workers behind the scenes. The people who are working behind the database scenes are as the database system designers and implementers, and tool developers and operators and maintenance personnel. First, the database system designer and implementers. He designs and implements the database management system modules and interface as a software packages. Second, the tool developers. He designs and implements tools, the software packages that facilitate database modeling and design, the database system design, and improved performance. And next one is the operators and maintenance personnel. He is responsible for actual running and maintenance of the hardware and the software environment for the database system. And next is the advantages of using the database management system. There are several advantages, and first one is the controlling redundancy, providing storage structures and search techniques for efficient query processing, and next, providing backup and recovery, providing multiple user interface, representing complex relationships among data, enforcing integrity constraints, and permitting inference and actions using rules.